General, is it really fair na sabihin ng mga pasaway po ang mga residente dyan?
Yeah, actually, they call this Badlungon or yung mga pasaway. There are several of them. And we really need to have a stricter and more effort to discipline these people. But we could do this with the help of our barangay officials. That's why we are harnessing the cooperation and collaboration with the different barangay tanods and all the force multiplier that we could get, to include the help of our armed forces personnel and the other contingents like the Bureau of Fire, the Philippine Coast Guard. Remember that Cebu City is geographically located in the middle. If you go south of Cebu province, you have to pass by Cebu City. If you go north, you have to pass by Cebu City. And Cebu City is encircled by mountains and the sea area wherein there's a lot of ports here that need to be as well contained, because that's how the movement of people are coming in and out of Cebu, through sea, through land, and through air.
Chiki.
Yes, General, sinabi ni Environment Secretary Roy Simato, no, na confident daw siya na after 2 weeks, papasok na sa GCQ ang Cebu. So ano ang naging basehan sa statement na ito? Nakita niyo ba yung evidence kung bakit niya nasabi itong statement na ito? At bakit kampanteng-kampante si Secretary Simato?
I think I have seen the real pictures. For one, some of the records of our health office here should be reconciled and harmonized, because the only thing that we have seen in some of the media outlets is only about active cases. We forget that there are a lot of recovery here in Cebu. Remember that Cebu City accounts for 2,284 recoveries, and the active is around 2,686, meaning the recovery is really high, almost 46%. And if we really ask the people to cooperate and stay at home, we could stop the bleeding, meaning the spikes of the 12 identified barangays. We could contain this, and probably in the next few weeks, we'll be able to stop the increasing number of daily accounting of COVID positive.